Hi, this is Sue from the Mountain Canary Company again. We're going to visit today about ladies and packers again, and this is going to be part three. Okay, go ahead, Ed.
Hi, folks. Boy, you're taller than me. And my blarney. You know, I got a couple stories more for you today. There's several more I could be telling, but we could run this thing forever. You got to remember, I had a lot of time up there working and had a lot of very interesting experiences. Some of my favorite memories with crews I've been with women. And they've been all kinds of walks of life. I've got animal trainers, scientists, housewives, school teachers. It's been really interesting. But they've all been really good hands. If they weren't, they weren't there for long. Story now. Women are pretty darn tough. My theory on this has been, if they can have babies, they can damn near do anything. I tell you, if it was up to me having a baby, the population would have fallen a long time ago. But Joey started working with me. Real interesting lady. Ex-police officer, ex-roofer, works for the state. Really a fascinating lady. Really a good hand. And our first trip was a bit of excitement. We were going in, and Josie lost the trail and rolled about 85 feet down the mountainside. And it was so steep that when I went to get to her, I also flew and made air three times bouncing down that hill. Found my own log to land up behind. Nobody was hurt. Everything was fine. But just the kind of drama that took on, and that's a rare, rare experience, let me tell you, with me, really rare. But that kind of experience and that drama should have sent her packing. That was her first trip. Actually, her first time going into the backcountry. She'd come up on a bit of a road area the first day. And it should have sent her packing. It didn't. She showed up next job to go to work again. I was pretty impressed. Now, it probably would have scared me away. But the second one is, I got a story for you. It's written up in several places. It usually starts out with, "Sue, do you have your knife?" I was sitting home one day. I wasn't packing. I was sitting home that day. Day off. I had the Barbie going. I was all set to cream in a couple burgers and open a can of beer. And I got a phone call from a friend who lived up near the Olympic National Forest, and who I'd known for years, and he said, "Ed, will you bring a pack animal up? I got to cut up a horse." I said, "Whoa, wait a minute. What do you mean cut up a horse?" He told me that a horse had been, even a friend had stopped, picked up his son's horse down the road, and then went riding with him. Well, the horse he was leading, the friend of mine was leading. And he led up this trail, like kind of a root ball, and kind of snicked through this thing. It's nothing. But it was something at that moment. Because his horse turned around and said, "I ain't going any further," and walked down on this fellow with this riding this big buckskin he used of his son's. Well, the big buckskin reared up, and lucky was he wasn't up on that narrow by the root ball, but he reared up, fell over backwards, landed on the guy, and partly rolled off of the trail. Well, it killed the horse. He took a stab right between the eyes, and he was busted up. Man, when he did a job of him, because when we got there, he was bleeding out of all of his orifices. And the guy broke his sternum. So we had a bit of a drama there going on, a bit. So soon I got together, gathered up our stuff, called another fellow to come out and help, and headed up there. We were up to like 1:30 or so, and we started. I set up some rigging, let me backtrack. I called the Forest Service, and they said, "Well, geez, Ed, we run a real busy trail. Geez, Ed, can you, instead of cutting it up and dragging this bleeding horse out, won't piss all these people, could you just drag it off the trail into the brush?" And said, we knew it was in a stream. Otherwise, they'd have said, "Well, just throw it in the brush and leave it there." This is the old days. Well, can you get it off? I said, I think I can. So if you can, try. So, well, send me up somebody for the Forest Service, because this trail's busy and I don't want the political crap going on. And so they sent me a couple firefighters up. They were stationed out of that office. So there we are. We're back in there. We got this horse down in this gully. Off back, more or less, and dared a brick, and hooked it up. I started winching it out with come-alongs. I wasn't moving this critter. I had to move it up a steep bank, probably, maybe 8 feet. But, man, it was like a 1,500-pound animal, and it just didn't have the leverage to get him up there. So I decided, you know, we're going to have to take parts of this. We're going to take part of him out. And then drag those parts out and throw them over the bank into the woods. So the guys were all standing around, and Sue had already been down in the ditch. She was down in there with the firefighter. She'd already been down in the ditch. And I'm watching these guys all stand in a circle looking at their boots. And I'm thinking, I'm going to take charge of this. We got to get this done. I'm not going to be here all night. So I said, okay, first thing to do instead of acting like somebody important, I said, well, let's inventory knives. Because I knew they were going to dull knives. I didn't know how many knives I had, so I knew what I had, knew what Sue had, but I didn't know anybody else. So as I said that, I yelled down to Sue, Sue, do you have your knife to start this? Because if she responded, everybody else would be more comfortable responding. And all I heard was click. What was that? And then she said something to the fireman, and it's about dragging this animal's leg out of the way. And next thing you know, she's cutting the damn neck off this horse. I mean, she's in there slicing the sucker up, and all the guys going, huh? So me and I went right back by rigging right away, gets this set up, because I know where the neck comes off, I'm going to get that thing out of there. So she's down there, and she's actually working this over like she knew what she's doing. I think she did. And as she finally got down to the bony areas where she couldn't get through the bone, so the fireman went over, got his chainsaw, fired it up, whacked the rest of that off. And a funny thing, sidebar of the story, was I know he was retiring. That was his last day on the job. He was retiring the next day. So I'll bet you money, no fireman. He just kind of stuck that back on the rig and said, let's see what the next shift thinks of this. Well, anyhow, so Sue's down there. We get this hooked up. I drag the head out. We hook up to the body. I'm able to drag the body up, and we got it over and out of the way. And we've got the other firemen up there running people down the road. Don't stop here type thing. And then out from the ditch comes Sue. Ooh, she's mad. She is really mad at me. What the hell did I do? She's mad at me. She's mad at an old wet hen. She's just spitting mad. You made me cut that neck off that horse. I said, what do you mean I made you cut the neck off that horse? I said, all I did, dear, was ask you if he had your knife. Well, as soon as I heard that, I knew you were going to make me do it, so I just went ahead and did it. So now the story here, folks, is, man, taking ladies along doesn't mean we take along a snowflake. I've seen some guys I've been with that, I tell you, they're not a fraction as tough as any of the ladies I've had to go with me. And through the things they've gone through, the weather and the conditions, and sleeping on the ground, everybody finding their own special rock to lay on. No. Let me tell you, the truth in the pudding is, women are damn tough, and they make really good pack partners. And ladies, when you're listening, if you're listening to this and patting yourselves on the back, start thinking, I wonder if I could be a packer too. So get out there and learn how to do this. Get your own equipment, your own animals. Get up there, cowboy up and get over there and learn to do this. You can do it. Believe me. Take my word for it. I don't lie. Take my word for it. You can do it. Thank you, folks, very much for coming by and putting up with this. And I tell you what, don't forget, ride as often as you can, but please, please, please ride safely, because I'd like to have you back here again. We'll see you later.